Hello friends, here in this video we will see a problem on calculation of moment of inertia for a given cutout section. Here is a question. Calculate MI of the section about centroidal axis as shown in figure. So here the section is given and in this square has been subtracted. So here which I am shading, material is there only in this region. So only this much section has material, here this square has been subtracted and we have to find the MI of the section about the centroidal axis, that is about XX and about YY axis. So this is the question. Now when we are trying to find the moment of inertia, before that we should know the centroid, the where it is located. So first we are going to locate that centroid. So in the solution part, since location of centroid with respect to y-axis is given by x bar is equal to, here the total distance is 150 and this is the y axis of the complete section. So x bar is the distance of this y axis and this x bar will be half of 150, that is the total width. So it comes out to be 75 mm. So we have x bar as 75 mm from one side and even from the other side it will be 75 mm. Now after getting the y axis for the section, we know that centroid will be there on this y axis, but at which height, that we do not know. For that we require y bar value, and for getting the y bar value, here I'll say that this bigger rectangle will be area 1 for us, whereas this square will be area 2 for us. So here I'll write the formula of y bar, that is therefore location of centroid with respect to x axis is given by y bar is equal to a1 into y1 minus a2 into y2 upon a1 minus a2. So I'll keep this as the first equation. Now we need to know individual areas and the y1 y2 values. So therefore a1 will be the area of bigger rectangle, that is 150 into 300, and it is 45 into 10 raised to 3 mm square. Area 2 will be area of this square, so it is 50 into 50, so that is 2.5 into 10 raised to 3 mm square. Next, y1 is the location of x axis for the first rectangle and its x axis will be at half of 300. This is the x-axis for rectangle number 1, so 1, 1, it will be at half of 300. that is 150 mm, and y2 will be the location of x-axis for the square, and it is 50. So y2 is 50 plus half of this 50, so it is 75 mm. After getting them, we'll put it in equation number 1. Therefore, put all values in equation number 1. So we have y bar as, it is a1 y1 minus a2 y2 upon a1 minus a2. So a1 is 45 into 10 raised to 3, y1 is 150 plus a2 2.5 into 10 raised to 3, y2 is 75 upon a1, it is minus a2. So therefore y bar, it comes out to be 154.41 mm from bottom, because the references for y distance, we have taken it from bottom. This will be y bar. Next, I'll get y bar even from top. So here, from the total height, which is 300, we will subtract 154.41, and so the answer will be 145.59 mm from top. Now, after getting the y bar values, we can locate it on the diagram. 154.41 mm from bottom. So here we have the location of y axis for the rectangle number 1. This was at 150 mm from bottom, but the x axis of the complete system is at 154.41 mm from bottom, so just above this axis. There will be the x axis of the complete section, from bottom. And from the top, it was 145.59 mm. So here I have located the x-axis, which is here. The x-axis for the complete section, previously we were having y-axis for the complete section. Wherever they intersect, that will give us the centroid G. Now, once the centroid has been located, we can go for the calculation of moment of inertia. So now, once we have located the x-axis for the complete section, now we can go for the calculation of moment of inertia. So I'll say that, therefore, MI about horizontal centroidal axis is given by IXX is equal to IXX1 minus IXX2. So here I'll keep this as the second equation Next, first we'll calculate IXX1. So therefore, IXX1 is equal to MI about horizontal centroidal axis for rectangle 1. It is given by IXX1 is IG1 plus area 1 into H1 square. This is by parallel axis theorem. So now if we look into this figure, here the x-axis of rectangle number 1, it is at half of 300, that is 150, but the x-axis for the complete system is at 154.41 mm. So there is some difference between the two axes, and this difference will be called as H1. So therefore IXX1 will be, now IG1 is the moment of inertia for the first rectangle about its own axis, that is at 150 mm. So IG1 is BD cube by 12, area is B into D, H1 square. So therefore IXX1 is, here B and D values for the rectangle number 1, B is 150, D is 300. 150 into 300 cube divided by 12 plus B into D, area for the first figure we have found out it was 45 into 10 raised to 3. Now H1, as we can see from the diagram, it is 154.41 minus 150 square. So if we calculate this throughout, the answer comes out to be IXX1 is equal to 338 into 10 raised to 6 mm raised to 4. Next, IXX2, since IXX2 is MI about horizontal centroidal axis for square, which is the second figure. So therefore IXX2 will be IG2 plus area 2 into H2 square, again by parallel axis theorem. Now if we look into the diagram, then the x-axis for square is located at 75 mm distance from bottom, but the x-axis of the complete system is at 154.41 mm. So there is distance between the two axes. Here this is 75 mm. So the difference between these two axes, that is x-axis for square and the x-axis of the complete system, that will be H2. So it will be 154.41 minus 75, and that is why we are using parallel axis theorem. So therefore IXX2 will be, now even for the second figure, which is a square, the MI about horizontal axis formula will be BD cube by 12, same as that for the rectangle, plus area is B into D into H2 square. Therefore IXX2 will be, here if we see in the diagram, B is 50 and even D is 50. So 50 into 50 cube divided by 12 plus area was 2.5 into 10 raised to 3. Now H2 is 154.41 minus 75. If we go on calculating this throughout, IXX2 value will be 16.30 into 10 raised to 6 mm raised to 4. Now after getting IXX1, IXX2, we can put their values in second equation to get IXX. So therefore, put IXX1 and IXX2 in equation number second. So we have IXX is equal to IXX1 338 into 10 raised to 6 minus IXX2 16.30 into 10 raised to 6. So therefore IXX value will be 321.70 into 10 raised to 6 mm raised to 4. This will be the first answer. Next, after getting IXX1, we can say that the MI about horizontal centroidal axis for this figure, which is located at the x-axis, is at 154.41 mm. So we have calculated the MI about this horizontal axis. Now we need to calculate MI about the vertical axis. So here I'll say that therefore MI about vertical centroidal axis is given by IYY is equal to IYY1 minus IYY2. Keeping this as equation number 3. Now, it is very simple in the calculation of IYY and IYY2 that if we look into the diagram, the y-axis of rectangle number 1 will be at 75 mm distance from left hand side. Similarly, so now here we have IYY as IYY1 minus IYY2. So therefore IYY1 is the moment of inertia for the first rectangle about its y-axis. First rectangle, its y-axis is passing at 75 mm distance, and even the y-axis for the complete shaded section is at 75, so there is no gap between the two axes, and that is why we won't be using parallel axis theorem here, but calculating it by directly using the formula about y-axis. So for rectangle 1, the formula is db cube by 12 about y-axis. Therefore, IYY1 will be, now for rectangle number 1, D is 300 and B is 150. So from this, IYY1 value comes out to be 84.38 into 10 raised to 6 mm raised to 4. Next, similarly, IYY2 will be equal to db cube by 12 again. If we look into the diagram, then the y-axis for this square is passing at 75 mm from left hand side, and even the y-axis for complete shaded section is at 75 mm distance. So both the axes are at the same distance, so passing through the same line. Hence, there is no difference and we can't use parallel axis theorem here. So directly using dB cube by 12. So therefore, IYY2 will be your D and B values. For the square, D is 50 and even B is 50. So 50 into 50 cube by 12. So here IYY2, it comes out to be 520.83 into 10 raised to 3 mm raised to 4. So this is IYY2. Now we'll put the values of IYY1 and IYY2 in equation 3. So therefore, put IYY1 and IYY2 in equation number 3. So therefore, IYY will be equal to IYY1 is 84.38 into 10 raised to 6, IYY2 520.83 into 10 raised to 3. So after subtracting them, the answer of IYY comes out to be 83.85 into 10 raised to 6 mm raised to 4. This is the second answer. So if we look into the question, there were two things asked, IXX and IYY. Moment of inertia about centroidal axis, XX and YY. So the first answer we have found out, it was 321.70 into 10 raised to 6 mm raised to 4. IXX is done. Similarly, IYY we have found out 83.85 into 10 raised to 6 mm raised to 4. And with both these questions solved, we can say that the problem has been completed.